All right, so apparently 250 pounds of Merlot grapes yields this much wine, which was really surprising to me because I got an extra 3 gallons in a carboy that I wasn't expecting. So that was kind of a nice bonus. But basically, I have 2 5-gallons and 3 3-gallons, so 19 gallons is what it yielded. And obviously, there's lees at the bottom of each one of these that I'm gonna rack off. So it's not gonna be 19 in the end. It'll probably be closer to about 17, but still a lot of wine. But basically what I wanted to show you guys was you can see that this is right after the press, and you can see that I didn't fill each carboy up into the neck, and there's a reason for that. And that's because I pressed these guys about 3 to 3.5 bricks still left to go. And the reason why I did that is because, for one, I was going to work the next day and I thought that they would have dropped below zero. And I always like to press a little bit before zero. And just to kind of err on the safe side, and plus I like to leave some of the nutrients left on the wine when I add malolactic bacteria. And right after I got done pressing and bringing these guys inside, I added the malolactic bacteria. So anyway, what happens is when these guys are still fermenting, there's still a lot of foam. And if you were to fill these up into the neck, the foam would just come right out the airlock and basically ruin your wine. So right after press, if they're not fermented to completion, and even if they are a little bit, I would always not fill it up until I know that I don't even see any microbubbles coming up the side. So that's just kind of erring on the side of caution there. Also, you don't have to worry about this gap here because you can see that these airlocks are still burping and it's creating a blanket of CO2 on the top of these. So as long as these are still going off, you don't have anything to worry about as far as oxidation goes. But as soon as these calm down a little bit, I'm definitely gonna top these guys up. And I got a phone call coming in. Oh wait, those are just messages. They can wait. So yeah, I think that's it that I wanted to update you guys on. This is about, let's see, about 18 hours after press. So they're still quite active, and it'll probably be like a day or two before they calm down quite a bit. But tomorrow, I'm gonna pick up some bottles of Merlot so that when these do slow down, I already have the wine to top them up with. And when I first started making wine, I used to think, you know, using commercial wine to top up your carboys was kind of strange and, you know, kind of not legit because you're buying wine and putting it in your own wine. But I'll tell you what, you've got to do it because if you don't fill that gap, then you're exposing that entire top layer to oxygen. And you don't want to do that. When these guys calm down, I'm going to fill this guy about, I don't, anywhere from a half an inch to 3/4 of an inch below this bung here. And that's to reduce the oxygen exposure. So topping up with commercial wine is a must, unless you have some of your old wine that you've made to do that with. So anyway, thanks for stopping by. Stay tuned.